There are two areas in your life where you are feeling that there's a need for change, but you have so many options and you are not yet sure regarding which option to prioritize. What should you decide finally, right? So we are discussing of this Venus retrograde, which I see as padrikpanchang.com is happening on 19th December 2021. And Venus goes direct on 29th of January. So the last 12 days of this year and the first 29 days of next year, Venus will be retrograde. And till end of this year, he will be in Capricorn and almost. And then I think from the last day, 31st December or 1st of January, as you feel like it's entering back into Sagittarius. All right, so Venus is now in Sagittarius as of today, and he's actually slowing down. Okay, and by 19th, which is another 15 days, he will quite slow down further, and on 19th he will be retrograde. So this is a very interesting position for Venus to be, because if you see, Venus is getting retrograde in the sign of Capricorn, right? The retrogression is starting from there. And we know who is sitting in Capricorn. Shani Maharaj is in Capricorn, and Saturn and Venus, they are yog karakas in each other's ascendants, right? So we know that whenever we have a Capricorn or Aquarius Lagna, then Venus is the yog karak. And for Libra and Taurus, we have Saturn as the yog karak, right? So they're very good friends because they represent the dualities of the material world, right? Which means, now sometimes people think that how in the universe are Saturn and Venus friends? Why? Because not because that the traits which they represent are friendly. They are totally opposite, if you see, right? Venus represents pleasure, youth, beauty. Saturn represents suffering, old age, and like not able to provide for anything, right? Venus is attraction, Saturn is repulsion, right? It's exactly the opposite. But the fact of life is that both the things are together. Today you may be very attractive, very beautiful, very charming, but one day you will not remain, right? You will one day become old and everything will dwindle and you will leave this world one day. And Venus represents bhoga and Saturn represents tyag. And as we know from the scriptures that people, all of us, keep dwindling between bhoga and tyag, right? Sometimes we enjoy too much and then we are frustrated. Then we say, ah, we'll give this up. We'll not do this anymore. Then we go to tyaga. And then after some time, when we are in tyaga, we feel bored, we feel empty, we feel lonely, we feel there's nothing, there's nobody. So let's go back to bhog again, right? And therefore, during this conjunction and during this retrogression, we may feel this dance between the pendulum more actually, and all the more because Saturn is the Lord of Capricorn, and he's also sitting there. And see, Capricorn in general can represent Tyaga, which is required for us to make some serious commitments in life. Okay, so therefore, Venus is retrograde for around 40-41 days. So during this time, it is very essential for us to look deep down within our life and see what are those things related to the houses that Venus rules in your chart. So if Venus is your 10th lord, then your profession, your career, your self-employment, your own business, something which is like your own, your independent identity. That's the 10th house, right? So if Venus is your 10th lord and he's getting retrograde, then it could mean that you might have to sacrifice a part of what you like in order to become great. Because see what happens when Venus is retrograde. Venus will be in very soon, he will be in very close proximity with the Sun, and the Sun will cross Venus, right? And then eventually Venus will again start moving. Because of this, it's like purification. Okay, so when you put gold into fire, what happens? Gold shines more, right? So therefore, this time of the end of this year and beginning of new year, the first month actually. So these 40 days are very good. These are like amazing times for us to actually see how we can go to the next level, right? So Venus retrograde this time in Capricorn will force us to go to the next level, because every next level of your life will demand a different version of you, right? Let me repeat. Every next version of life will demand a different version of you. If you know certain things are not working for you, then give it up. Don't stick to it. If you know certain patterns, if you have observed that certain patterns are repeating again and again and again in your life, you do something and then something else happens, then change those patterns, right? It's easier said than done, but you got to do it. Otherwise, you will be in the same place. And along with that, if you see, Saturn is also in Capricorn. So because of that, what happens is, we kind of get this feeling that the tyaga is much more than the bhog, right? So the sacrifice has to be more compared to the pleasure, okay? So therefore, you really have to make up your mind. Do you really want to go to the next level? Because if you don't, then you will remain in Capricorn, right? So first, you might have to make some sacrifice. So see which houses Venus is ruling in your chart, depending on your ascendant. And related to those houses, you ask yourself, make an objective analysis by trying to identify what are those things which you have to give up to go to the next level, and what is the price that you have to pay, right? So you might have to pay a good price, a heavy price. And once you pay that, you have to start implementation, because by end of the year, Saturn, Venus will again enter Sagittarius, which is the sign of divine inspiration, wisdom, knowledge, divinity and God and spirituality, gurus, guides, counselors. So therefore, you could also take help of your gurus, your guides, your counselors, or your astrologers, or your seniors in the family, your mother, father, or your elders or seniors within your company to navigate through this. Because just because you say, I will sacrifice something, it doesn't mean you will be successful, right? So good guidance will be required. For example, suppose you say, okay, I need to learn something. Suppose Venus is your fourth lord. So then you might have to sacrifice going to parties in the weekends, or you might have to learn something, right? So that will require time. But just because by not going to parties in the weekends, and if you just sit down to study, does it mean you will achieve all success? Well, necessarily not, right? So whenever Sagittarius is involved, it is best to take guidance from some higher power, right? So in this case, higher power means somebody who has already gone through that path through which you plan to walk, okay? So therefore, if you are depending on the houses which Venus rules, it's good if you can get some personal coaching in that particular area of life, okay? So if it's the seventh house, then it could be related to your marriage or people who have had successful marriages, okay? So 10th house, as I said, you could take help of a career counselor or somebody who is in the line 10 years senior to you, where you want to be, right? Senior doesn't mean just by year or a number of years in the profession or just by age, but senior really means by experience, right? Because many people they have seen a lot of years, seniors, but they don't become a senior, right? So it's seeing years doesn't make you a senior, right? So be a senior, not just a seniors fellow. So therefore, anybody who is very dedicated and has the right guidance and right context, so it's best if we can take guidance from them. And along with it, we have to stick to the sacrifice that we have, we will have to make sometime, okay? So therefore, now we almost have like 15 days for this retrogression to happen, and that is why I made this video earlier, so that we can actually get a realistic estimate of how much we have to sacrifice. Now, what you will have to sacrifice, to what extent, well, all these things will depend on your horoscope and your dashas, how your Venus is in the original birth chart, all right? But in short, the essence is that you got to pay a price. There are no freelancers in this material world. Nothing is for free, all right? If you don't understand this, then you will not be able to make any material or any spiritual progress. You have to have dedicated commitments, all right? So whenever Venus goes retrograde, it's like things related to Venus, which is indicated in your chart by the lordships of Venus, they go for self-doubt and there's like this change of thought process inside, okay? So therefore, don't think that you will be successful without paying any price. That's a brutal, honest thing that we have to understand, right? So therefore, rather than running away from that which you know that you should sacrifice, instead, why not face that, right? Because the more you run away, the more you are away from your goal, right? And the more you face your fears, the more you come close to the goal. Because see, many times we fear that, oh, we have to do this, you know, we can't pay this price, we can't sacrifice so much for this, right? But then even by not doing, we are miserable because the guilt is killing us inside, the guilt of not doing that, right? So either ways, either you die by pain or by guilt. So better is to take pain and, as they say, no pain, no gain. So just don't work hard. Work hard in the right direction under the guidance of somebody who you are, who you trust and who can actually guide you and who has been where you are and who also is there where you want to be one day, all right? So once you do this together, then you will see a rapid change, rapid development, and the houses that Venus rules in the chart for the next 18 months again will be quite stabilized, okay? And if you waste this time, the next 2 months, then after the beginning of February, you will lament, why did I not do, right? So the beauty is you are aware of astrology. You know this. There are billions of people in this world. But they might not have any idea what is Venus or what is retrogression of Venus, right? So they will also do it subconsciously. But because you are seeing this video, you are aware of astrology and Venus, you can do it more consciously. That's the beauty of knowing astrology, right? You can't change anything, but you can be more conscious and you can use these planetary energies to the best possible capacity, okay? Up to depending on your situation, of course, all right? Thank you very much, and see you soon again.